So I just commuted home and I've still been listening to Mel Robbins' book and had some more takeaways I wanted to share with you guys. I was always the type of person who would see the self-help section in a bookstore and kind of roll my eyes or think about personal development and just think like, man, what kind of messed up person needs that? And it's been one of my favorite parts of becoming a coach and prioritizing personal development, because I have learned so much about myself and about people and how to lead, and I've grown so much. I like sharing what I'm learning, because if one person can listen to a podcast or pick up a book they wouldn't have and have an aha moment, it's worth sharing. So the most recent chapter I was listening to was about fixed versus a growth mindset. And I think if you had asked me, you know, what type of mindset do you have, I would have thought, oh, I have a growth mindset, thinking that I did. But if I'm honest, I think for a long time growing up, I had a very fixed mindset. I think I just saw things more in black and white, that you were athletic or you weren't, you were smart or you weren't. And I thought that, you know, I had these titles on me and I wanted to be perfect in every way. I had a kind of just like a high achieving mindset, and I was hard on myself, and I still can be, and thought, you know, like, you know, I'm smart, I get good grades, or I'm athletic and I have to achieve these things. And I put a lot of pressure on myself. And what was hard is if I wouldn't live up to my expectation, I would feel terrible, like I failed, and I hated that feeling. And what it ended up doing was it made me kind of retreat from trying. And it sounds silly, but I think as I look back over my life, it caused me to procrastinate in a lot of ways. It made me not practice things. I mean, just examples, when I was in school, I wouldn't study for a test until the night before. And I think it gave myself an excuse of, you know, if I don't do as well as I want, or I don't do as well as so-and-so, it's because I didn't study. And, you know, I didn't practice my clarinet for auditions, because if I didn't make first chair, then I could at least tell myself, well, I didn't practice, so no wonder I didn't get it. And just little things like that, where I didn't put the effort I should have, because I was putting so much pressure on being perfect that I didn't put that effort in. And I lived like that for a long time. Something that has kind of given me an aha moment, which this is so silly, so bear with me, but doing handstands. I was a gymnast when I was little, but kicking up into a handstand and being able to balance on your hands for more than a second doesn't just happen. That's something that you have to practice. It's a skill. And after I had my first daughter, Gwen, I knew I could walk on my hands, but I wanted to be able to just hold it, you know? I thought that was impressive. And so just periodically during my study breaks to kind of get my mind off things and calm, just be in that place of calm where I was focused on something, I would start doing handstands. Or if I was outside, just wanted to play, you know, I would do more handstands. And slowly over time, I was able to hold it longer and longer and do different types of styles and balance different ways. And it was really fun for me. And I just enjoyed that process of, yeah, day to day I didn't notice a big difference, but if I looked at videos and photos, I realized, holy cow, I couldn't do that a couple months ago, a couple years ago. And like I said, it's such a silly example, but I think it was the first time in my life that I intentionally put time and effort and consistency into something, and I saw that reward. And I'm sure there are better examples, but that was the thing that clicked for me of, you can make improvement. You can control the outcome. And it's more admirable in life to try hard and fail and learn and move forward and grow and just embrace the process of going through those things and learning and growing. That's how you make progress. That's how you move forward. And not being so concerned and obsessed with the outcome and the achievement and being perfect. So I hope that if you are in a place of a fixed mindset, that you can find your small thing, whether it's handstands or something more impactful, but something that just you can be okay with just trying and reward yourself for putting in the effort. And I've learned to give myself grace and get away from that perfection mindset so much since I've started pouring into audiobooks and learning about myself and so many things. And I hope I can pay that forward to just one person of, you don't have to be perfect. It's okay to just show up and try, because consistency over time is what breeds success.